Can someone get away with buying any of the device for almost all their work? Well, short answer is yes, and the long answer is why in the world would you? Hey guys, welcome again. Watch this video till the end and maybe in next 15 minutes you might be able to decide your next purchase. And the format of this video will be as follows: that first I'll be discussing about the differences between the iMacs, MacBooks, iPads based on their use case, benefits and disadvantages. Second, I'll be answering the question that can anyone get away with buying any of these devices for almost all of their used cases. And third, based on the categories, if you are a videographer, cinematographer, you do editing, coding, or you do casual web browsing or media consumption, which device should be best for you based on use case and budget. Now, I'm not going to cover here the Mac Mini and the super expensive Mac Pro, because if you are someone who needs that, you already know that and I don't need to convince you. It costs like a car. And Mac Mini, that can be compared with the iMacs, so you can kind of get away by saving few bucks and buying your own keyboard and monitor using Mac Mini. At the end of the video, I will answer which device I just pre-ordered. And I am not a Mac user so far, but they literally changed my mind with that particular device. Let's continue. Now this sound is getting recorded via Rode Wireless Go Mark II, so if you are interested into that, you can check my other video and this is how it sounds. Now all these devices, iMacs, MacBooks and iPads, they all come with kind of their light version, which is kind of their Air version, and their Pro version. Now let's start with iMac, both the M1 and the Intel processors. So this device is for the people who don't move around with their devices for works like editing, coding, offices, or for graphics designers, or maybe it's a common family computer where each of the people are using that, right? It's also great for movie watching because it has a great Retina display provided by the Apple itself. Now, what are the benefits of this? First of all, it's a hassle-free device. It's an all-in-one neat setup with just a monitor, keyboard and a mouse, which is wireless too, obviously. Now it's powerful because of the least thermal throttling, because it doesn't have to, you know, cramp everything on that closed space, which usually iPads and MacBook Pros have to do. And it has the best in class speaker in all the Apple, you know, category, if you don't want to buy an external speakers. Now let's talk about the disadvantages. So the first thing is portability. We all know that, right? You have to just keep it and use it. You cannot carry it around like your iPads and MacBooks. And it can go pretty expensive based on which variant you are purchasing. So yeah, that is that. But then which Apple product isn't? Let's talk about the MacBooks. MacBooks again have their light version, which is the Air, and the MacBook Pro variants. Now, I will come to the M1 versus Intel variants pretty soon. But then now mostly variants in the latest gen are coming with M1 processors, and that is what I would suggest people to buy for. Now who should buy this MacBook devices? Well, this is for anyone who doesn't want to compromise between the power and the performance. And it can be used for people like who are into coding, students who are into schools or college, who take notes or make documents. It can be used for graphic designers. There's a plethora of options, and not to mention the screen quality of their Retina displays. They are amazing. So best in class media consumption too. These are the people who want that portability without, you know, sacrificing into much of the performance. They should go for the MacBooks. Now coming to a disadvantage, well, we all know that MacBooks compared to their Intel counterparts are pretty expensive, but then they are quite well built, and these devices have longer range when compared to the plastic build of most of the, you know, devices. So once you buy these devices, you kind of tend to use them for few years, if not just for one or two. Let's come to the device, which is iPad, which is pretty exciting for most people because of its portability, ultra portability, I should say. You can go for iPad Air, or you can choose the iPad Pro, which can be 11 inch or 12.9 inch. Now coming to the point that who is this device for? Well, people who want amazing browsing experience, I should say best in class when compared to similar devices, or who are looking for media consumption like binge watching movies and all, or people who want handwritten notes, especially because this is the device which supports Apple Pencil. So for students, college, teachers, and people who want to do some sort of hybrid work, like they want to use it with the keyboard, without the keyboard, whatever way you want, and obviously for the artists, because it supports Apple Pencil and it has a touch screen. So yeah, this is for those people. Benefits, first benefit is ultra portability because you can take it anywhere. And the second benefit is it's kind of a hybrid device. You can use with the keyboard or you can use without the keyboard, up to you, but you know, those are separate, you have to purchase them. Third thing is screen quality, Super Retina, especially the XDR display, which is about to come in the 12.9 inch M1 variant, outstanding. Coming to disadvantages, well, this list is huge because we are comparing it with the desktop and the laptop variant. So the first disadvantage is its price can go pretty high based on what specced out version you want to buy. Especially the keyboards, they are pretty expensive, like, you know, $350-$400 for just the Magic keyboards. In India, it costs $32,000 for the 12.9 inch, the latest M1 iPad, which is outrageous. You can go for the cheaper version Folio, but then again, these are extra accessories. Apple Pencil, that is like $130 or around $11,000 in India. So it can get pretty expensive based on which version you want to buy. Air is the best model, but I will come to that in the second segment of this video because it offers almost the best of all the worlds. Second disadvantage is it's pretty expensive to get it repaired because iPad is something which is like a mobile device which you'll be carrying with a lot, and its screen is kind of glass. It is prone to damage. If it happens, the bill will be like punching a hole in your wallet. Third disadvantage is the ecosystem. Well, iPad OS is not as powerful as the Big Sur of the MacBooks, so we all know, right, what I'm talking about. There's no full-fledged support for the softwares like Final Cut Pro or Logic Pro, but that might change with the new M1 processor in the iPad Pros. Hope to see what Apple has in the bucket next. Today it's 8th of May and I don't know as of today what's coming for the new M1 processor backed iPad Pros. Maybe Apple has stepped up their game and improved their ecosystem, right? Okay, coming to the important segment, which is the question of the hour. Can someone get away with buying any of the device for almost all their work? Well, short answer is yes, and the long answer is why in the world would you? Listen for a second. See, if your work involves a lot of typing, creating documents, notes, or submitting things, presentations, things like that, which involves a lot of typing, you know, a lot of typing. Obviously, you want something which has the keyboard built in. And if portability is required, MacBook is no-brainer. It can be a MacBook Air, it can be the Pro. Now, iPads can do that too, but it becomes cumbersome and equally heavy when you use their Magic, keyboard, where it levitates. It's cumbersome. You have to kind of use that, and until unless you're kind of a hybrid user where you use a little bit of that, a little bit of other thing, then it makes no sense to buy an iPad. Now, on the other hand, if your use case is more on the casual, I want a secondary device, or I want a primary device mainly for web browsing, casually gaming, or watching content online, lying upside down in the bed, whatever way you want, then it's a no-brainer that iPad is the choice. No-brainer. It is the easiest choice. On the other hand, if you want consistent performance, a system which stays on your desk, or probably a common computer for your whole family, then it's simply iMac because it's powerful, it doesn't throttles, and it works as long as you want to work with an amazing display. That's very important here. It has amazing display. So that is the iMac. Now, which variant you have to buy, like the lighter version, the Air versions, or the expensive versions, Pro versions in iMac, the M1, or the specced out Intel, it completely depends upon you. I cannot answer that. But I can tell you one thing, you can get away with iPad Air for almost everything. You can get away with MacBook Air for almost everything, the M1 variants, because the M1 chip is pretty powerful and it has proved itself quite a lot. So depending upon your budget, depending upon your use case, you have to choose between them. If you are a hardcore user and you are looking into 4-5 years, specced out variant is the best, but we don't have any other alternative right now in MacBook Air. It comes with M1, the latest processor. Now for iMac, we are still into gray area because they offer just M1 on their new colorful iMacs, or you know, the specced out Intel variants, you can go up to as high you want. But I'm expecting that they soon will be releasing an A1X or A2 processor with, you know, new MacBook Pros and iMacs. So wait for that. Now this is the third segment of this video. category wise, if you're a student, a teacher, someone who uses a lot of presentation documents, you need notes. Well, if handwritten notes is not a priority, the MacBook Air will be more than sufficient. The M1 processor, until a new upgrade comes out, is literally amazing. You don't need anything more than that. On the other hand, if you need handwritten notes, then you know, iPads. iPad Air is the choice again in terms of iPads, because you can get with almost everything done on iPad and you will not, you know, break a sweat. One thing, if you carry around a lot, because you know, you might be moving from canteen, cafeterias to your libraries, do invest in a sleeve, because if these devices fall, they punch again a hole in your wallets. Now you might be thinking, iPad Pro, the older generation with the A12 Bionic chip, I think it was A12Z Bionic chip, versus the iPad Air with A14. Well, let me tell you, iPad Air 4, the one which comes with A14 Bionic chip, is powerful enough that you should not consider the iPad Pro, the previous generation. On the other hand, the new upcoming iPad Pro M1, it's a different game altogether. And if you are a student, a teacher, almost 95% of the time, you will not need that level of performance. And obviously the price, it's kind of like, I think probably 30-40% more expensive. No, it's 50% more expensive than iPad Air. So you will not need that. And that's the entry model which I'm talking about. So yeah, you don't need the new iPad Pro M1. You don't need to look at the old iPad Pro. You just go for iPad Air if you are a teacher or a student. For coding and office work, using like workstation, MacBook Pro, easy choice. Go for the M1 processors. Wait if you can, because another variant might be coming soon with a bit larger device, like 14 inch. This is 13 inch. You can go for 14 inch or more, it will be great. Now for the editors, graphic designers, things like those, MacBook Pro 16 inch if it comes in, you know, new processors, or the iMacs, because you need consistent performance and you don't want, you know, throttling here and there. So depending upon your use case, if you want portability, you should go for the MacBook Pro, obviously the largest screen possible. I really hope with their new processors they release something like 16 inch variant. It is very useful to, you know, edit on a larger screen. On the other hand, I'm expecting them to release a bigger variant of, you know, iMac 2, but iMac M1 is also good for almost mid-level of editing and photo or video or maybe graphics designing. Now the final thing is for artists. Well, you know, you need iPad Pro, and I would suggest go for the iPad Pro M1. And which variant you should go for, 11 inch or 12.9 inch, it's completely up to you, because if you prefer portability, I think 11 would be a better choice. 12.9 would feel more like a laptop moving around. So if you're someone who draws at, you know, roadside benches or next to river, whatever place you want to draw, 11 inch might be just perfect for you. It supports Apple Pencil, so you have to invest in that too. So you have to consider that price. But in artist's world, it says bigger the better, so 12.9 inch is the best choice, but portability wise, 11 inch iPad Pro is better. Remember, go for M1 as of 2021, iPad Pro M1. Listen, write it down, iPad Pro M1. So finally, for the people who want just casual browsing, a bigger, better screen, media consumption, look at nothing else, go for iPad Air 4 with A14 Bionic chip. Listen, you don't need anything more than that. Don't go into that trap of iPad Pro's amazing display, amazing things, amazing processor. You will not need that performance for your day-to-day casual activities like web browsing, shopping, or YouTube, or Netflix and all. iPad Air should be sufficient for you. Just simply go for that. You can try it at any of your stores and you will know what I'm talking about. Now guys, that's all I had for you today. And yes, to answer my question, I have ordered the 11 inch iPad Pro M1 256GB variant. Why this model? Why not the 12.9? If you want those answers, probably I'll make a separate video. But in my opinion, Apple has reached, like in terms of innovation, to a status where I can quite rely on that iPad Pro M1s for most of my work. So that's all I had for you today. If you have any questions, you can list them down in the comment section. If someone has an opinion, please list that down too, so that others can benefit. Remember, this is a community. Nobody is perfect here. So I would love to hear your opinions, and so that people can benefit, me too. See you again, see you soon. Please don't forget to subscribe if you love this video. And yeah, before I go, stay safe and please stay indoors. Bye guys.